everybody, good evening, and welcome to another one of my evening video blogs. I'm Cosmic Claire, and I hope you've had a very lovely Beltane. Happy May Day, everybody. It's been a lovely day here in the western edge of Headingley, overlooking the Kirkstall Valley. So, spring does seem to be getting here at last. It's been long in coming. Well, I'll tell you what, I was thinking about the blog I did yesterday, and one thing that occurred to me was that it might have been a little bit abstract and obscure for some people. I tend to get a bit abstract and metaphysical sometimes, so I thought I would try to kind of bring it down to earth with a kind of practical side of this philosophy, and particularly since one of my friends on Facebook indicated that something I said was something he didn't understand. So I thought, well, this would kind of fit together, and so I'll take the opportunity to reply to that, because I was touching on the subject of being positive yesterday, or what it is to be, to have a positive attitude, or what positive thinking was. And I remember when there was a kind of burst of positive thinking-itis in the media a few years ago. A lot of people were shocked by people saying, oh, you know, we're taking a positive attitude to cancer and things like this, and I think that you know, cancer's just another opportunity, and this to me is not what positive thinking is about. I suppose it could be if you really stretch it, but you'd really have to get into the concept, I think. And I think it's you need to get into it in a more kind of gentle, humane way, and not these extravagant kind of overblown claims that people talk about. So what am I talking about? Well, positive thinking is, as I was talking about yesterday, is about your attitude to things. It's not about denying what exists, but it's about having an attitude of dealing with them positively. Now, about 3 years ago, I got I decided it was time to get into some serious self-development, because I'd gone through a couple of years of well, about 1.5 years of completely falling apart after certain situation occurred, which was I found hard to deal with at the time. And so in 2009 I started getting seriously into this self-development. There's a lot of resources out there on the internet in all sorts of angles on this. But what became rapidly clear was that at some level or other, we have some degree of influence over the outcomes of situations we find ourselves in. Now, I'm not suggesting a complete, what some people would describe as magical thinking, like, for instance, in The Secret. I think that is a very unbalanced kind of expression of what this is about. But the reason why it was so successful is probably because it did have a grain of important truth in it. Just as a lot of people, such as C.S. Lewis, have said, you know, even if something is a lie, it's believable if there's a bit of truth in it. It's often quite a job to be able to separate that grain of truth from the dross that might surround it, and this is a kind of the alchemical process, isn't it? Going through experiences to distill the essence not just in the experiences, but in ourselves, because it's ourselves in reflecting this that the learning pathway is really about anyway. So it's an interaction to refine the self. So what I said to this person on the Facebook thread was, I said, find good things to expand on with gratitude. And that in a way, I think, really sums up the philosophy that I've arrived at after 3 or so years of following this self-development pathway with some interesting and perhaps not so interesting teachers along the way. And I think that what's really important is to understand that the universe, or at least to treat the universe as if it were a conscious being, something like ourselves, perhaps more complex and vast, but nonetheless, because we are so stuck in this kind of just material separation, you know, I'm this body, you're that body, economic resources, blah blah blah, I want this, you want that, competing demands, all the multifarious expressions of that out in the world that I've talked about on other occasions. But actually, what the world really is one quantum creature, of which we are like individual neurons in this holistic cosmic brain. So the energy signals that we send out and the frequencies of the vibrations that we emit are going to have an influence on what comes back to us from the rest of the universe. Even if you only want to take this at the level of psychoanalysis, like Jungian or Freudian analysis, it's quite clear that when you look at something like a Rorschach picture, then what you project has a big influence on what you see. Obviously, there is raw data out there, and you know, if you see you know, a tiger coming towards you, then there's probably less room for variation. Whereas you see more ambiguous situations that will have all kinds of room for interpretation. As Ronald Reagan said in a different context, one man's terrorist is another man's freedom fighter. It's all about how we interpret things and what projections we put on them, where our values lie, and so forth. But if we place ourselves at the centre of the universe so that we're not trying to control, exploit, whatever, out of it, as you would in the separation universe model, where everybody's trying to get something off everybody else, if you are prepared to at least try, I mean, it's you know, it's an ongoing work, but to consider ourselves as being at the centre of a universal consciousness which surrounds us and which we are part of, but which is also reflects back to us some interpretation of what it is that we put out. So if we raise our vibrations, then the vibrations that are out there, which are of the same frequency, will tend to gravitate towards you. Now, this is a simple fact of physical resonance, which takes place at both the acoustic, physical, vibrational levels, and on the electromagnetic levels, And I see no reason to think that this same principle would not be present at the level of psychic emanations into the field, consciousness emanations, intentional thought emanations into the field of which we are all part and swimming. You might think of it as a consciousness counterpart to a magnetic field. I mean, the magnetic field. Nobody really understands what a magnetic field is. It's just a kind of propensity in space for charged particles to behave in a particular way, and which, you can't even touch it or see it in the same way as you can at least see, electrons as they, fluoresce through cloud particle chambers or whatever. Where am I going with this? Right, yeah, we're sending out these psychic consciousness thought emanations, and we're tuning into those ones in the universe. So if we're sending out thoughts of positive thoughts, not thoughts which are denying bad things which might be around us. It's not about that. But about sending out positive intention, which can, in due course, improve those other negative vibrations. And also, the other aspect of it, is the reinforcement aspect. Now, in taking it right down to the level of behaviorist science, this is something that is a reality and which is exploited by the powers that be, the powers that were. Reinforcement. Now, it's the case in behavioral psychology that positive reinforcement is more effective than negative reinforcement. Because if you have a particular desire to do something, all that's going to happen if you get negative reinforcement for it is you're going to feel frustrated, you're going to get drives turned inwards, it's going to cause I don't know, the psychic version of like an ingrown toenail. In other words, this is kind of what happens to a lot of people in cities because we all kind of turned in on ourselves and can't express myself, and the universe is oppressing me and it's all turned into me. I can't find my opportunities to express myself. Whereas. What we need to be looking for is turning that inside out so that it works the way that positive reinforcement works in psychology. If you do something, it works, and you get the positive reinforcement, not only positive self-reinforcement, self-congratulation, empowerment. But also you get the benefit of the thing which is being reinforced in the environment around you, and so it's all hunky-dory and we go forward. And this is how creative people have found the means of becoming themselves, expanding their influence and developing their creative powers. So if you have responses of resentment or revenge or attached anger and hatred, then you're likely to be in a situation, well, you will be in a situation where the universe responds that back to you. And this becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy because people, I've seen this before, and I've kind of skated on the edge of this at some periods of my life, but fortunately, I've never completely succumbed to it, because it is such a self-fulfilling prophecy. When people say, oh, you know, I don't trust anybody, everybody is, it's almost like I am the only sane person in the world, you know, which is, it's kind of a little bit insane, really, isn't it? Because to suggest that one is the only person that really cares or understands thing is kind of just like a monstrously egoistic statement. Because to let go of the ego, one really, you know, kind of would come to realize that probably everybody feels like that. You know, everybody feels like, what's going on? Everybody else knows better than me, or I know better than everybody else. It's, you know, two sides of the same coin. I've given up on the world, you can't trust anybody, blah, blah, blah. Now, it's a fine line, because there are a lot of people out there that you can't trust, but you have to learn to trust your own intuition to find out these differences. That's probably another pathway for another evening. So what I want to try and wrap this up with, basically, is that other people, the universe, respond to this positive attitude, an attitude of giving, an attitude of gratitude to other people. Responding to an attitude which reinforces the things which are good for people, wholesome, respectful of sensitivity, emotions, all these things. And so actually by turning this round and not putting it so much on what I have to have now, but realizing that that is actually part of the whole field. The whole field feels like this. So if you can actually turn this thing round so that you are giving the universe energy, and without any kind of demandingness back, because it actually finds the way back to you in the things that you have given. Or even if you just think of it in terms of other human people, what's it like? Who do you like? What sorts of people do you like? I'm sure we all like people who are generous, forgiving, light-hearted, don't take bad things too seriously, but with honesty, courage, people who have ideals, all these things. And so this is what it's about. This is what positive thinking is about. It's about living these things. It's about expressing them in our lives, being a conduit for the expression of the divine spirit, rather than the stultifying, the inward turning, the denying, the revengeful, because that only tears it apart and separates it. So coming from the position of seeing the universal spirit in everything, it binds us all together. I'm sounding like Obi-Wan Kenobi here. But this is true. There were great truths in those movies, and Obi-Wan Kenobi was a great spiritual teacher. And this is where the thing I end the saying with, the saying I end my talks with every night comes in, which is says, which means we are all different eyes of the same consciousness. I am another you, in Lakesh. Okay, thank you very much, everybody. I hope you've found some interest in this talk of mine this evening. Thank you very much. Good night.